Burt Lancaster, Burton Stephen Lancaster, November 2, 1913, October 20, 1994, was an American actor and producer. Initially known for playing tough guys, he went on to achieve success with more complex and challenging roles. He was nominated 4 times for Academy Awards, and won once for his work in Elmer Gantry in 1960. He also won a Golden Globe Award for the performance and BAFTA Awards for Birdman of Alcatraz, 1962, and Atlantic City, 1980. During the 1950s, his production company Hecht-Hill-Lancaster was highly successful, making films such as Trapeze, 1956, Sweet Smell of Success, 1957, Run Silent, Run Deep, 1958, and Separate Tables, 1958. The American Film Institute ranks Lancaster as number 19 of the greatest male stars of classic Hollywood cinema. Burton Stephen Lancaster was born on November 2, 1913, in Manhattan, New York, at his parents' home at 209 East 106th Street, the son of Elizabeth, née Roberts, and mailman James Henry Lancaster. Both of his parents were Protestants of working-class origin. All 4 of his grandparents were Irish immigrants to the United States, from the province of Ulster. His maternal grandparents were from Belfast and were descendants of English immigrants to Ireland. Lancaster grew up in East Harlem and spent much of his time on the streets, where he developed a great interest and skill in gymnastics while attending DeWitt Clinton High School, where he was a basketball star. Before he graduated from DeWitt Clinton, his mother died of a cerebral hemorrhage. Lancaster was accepted by New York University with an athletic scholarship, but subsequently dropped out. At 19, Lancaster met Nick Cravat, with whom he developed a lifelong partnership. Together they learned to act in local theater productions and circus arts at Union Settlement, one of the city's oldest settlement houses. They formed the acrobat duo Lang and Cravat in the 1930s, and soon joined the K Brother Circus. However, in 1939, an injury forced Lancaster to give up the profession, with great regret. He then found temporary work, first as a salesman for Marshall Field's and then as a singing waiter in various restaurants. With the United States having then entered World War II, Lancaster joined the United States Army in 1942 and performed with the Army's 21st Special Services Division, one of the military groups organized to follow the troops on the ground and provide USO entertainment to keep up morale. He served with General Mark Clark's 5th Army in Italy from 1943 to 1945. Lancaster returned to New York after his Army service. Although initially unenthusiastic about acting, Lancaster was encouraged to audition for a Broadway play by a producer who saw him while he was visiting his then-girlfriend at work. The audition was successful and Lancaster was cast in Harry Brown's A Sound Off Hunting, 1945. The show only ran 3 weeks, but his performance attracted the interest of a Hollywood agent, Harold Hecht. Lancaster had other offers, but Hecht promised him the opportunity to produce their own movies within 5 years of hitting Hollywood. Through Hecht, Lancaster was brought to the attention of producer Hal B. Wallace, who signed him to a non-exclusive 8-movie contract. Lancaster's first filmed movie was Desert Fury, 1947, for Wallace, where Lancaster was billed after John Hodiak and Elizabeth Scott. It was directed by Lewis Allen. Then producer Mark Hellinger approached him to star in The Killers, 1946, which was completed and released prior to Desert Fury. Directed by Robert C. Idmack, it was a great critical success, and launched Lancaster and his co-star Ava Gardner to stardom. It has since come to be regarded as a classic. Hellinger used Lancaster again on Brute Force, 1947, a prison drama written by Richard Brooks and directed by Jules Dassin. It was also well received. Wallace released his films through Paramount, and so Lancaster and other Wallace contractees made cameos in Variety Girl, 1947. Lancaster's next film was for Wallace, I Walk Alone, 1947, a thriller co-starring Scott and a young Kirk Douglas, who was also under contract to Wallace. It was a minor hit. Lancaster had a change of pace with the film adaptation of Arthur Miller's All My Sons, 1948, made at Universal with Edward G. Robinson. His third film for Wallace was an adaptation of Sorry, Wrong Number, 1948, with Barbara Stanwyck. Hecht kept to his promise to Lancaster to turn producer. The two of them formed a company, Norma Productions, and did a deal with Universal to make a thriller in England, Kiss the Blood Off My Hands, 1948, with Joan Fontaine and directed by Norman Foster. It was a commercial disappointment but critically acclaimed. Back in Hollywood, Lancaster did another film noir with Syed Mack, Criss Cross, 1949. It was originally going to be produced by Hellinger, and when Hellinger did another took over, Tony Curtis made an early appearance. Lancaster did a fourth for Wallace, Rope of Sand, 1949. Norma Productions signed a three-picture deal with Warner Brothers. The first was The Flame and the Arrow, 1950, a swashbuckler movie, in which Lancaster drew on his circus skills. Nick Cravat had a support role, and the film was a huge commercial success, making of $6 million. It was Warner's most popular film of the year and established an entirely new image for Lancaster. Lancaster was borrowed by 20th Century Fox for Mr. 880, 1950, a comedy with Edmund Quinn. MGM put him in a popular western, Vengeance Valley, 1951, then he went to Warner's to pay the title role in the biopic Jim Thorpe, All-American, 1951. Norma signed a deal with Columbia to make two films through a Norma subsidiary, Halbert. The first film was Ten Tall Men, 1951, where Lancaster was a member of the French Foreign Legion. Robert Aldrich worked on the movie as a production manager. The second was a comedy, The First Time, 1952, a comedy which was the directorial debut of Frank Tashlin. It was meant to star Lancaster, but he wound up not appearing in the film, the first of their productions in which he did not act. In 1951, the actor/producer duo changed the company's name to Hecht-Lancaster Productions. The first film under the new name was another swashbuckler, The Crimson Pirate, 1952, directed by Syed Mack. Co-starring Cravat, it was extremely popular. Lancaster changed pace one more by doing a straight dramatic part in Comeback, Little Sheba, 1952, based on a Broadway hit, with Shirley Booth, produced by Wallace and directed by Daniel Mann. Alternating with adventure films, he went into South Sea Woman, 1952, at Warner's. Part of the Norma Warner's contract was that Lancaster had to appear in some non-Norma films, of which this was one. Lancaster played one of his best-remembered roles with Deborah Curran from Here to Eternity, 1953, for Columbia, directed by Fred Zinnemann. The American Film Institute acknowledged the iconic status of the scene from that film in which he and Deborah Kerr make love on a Hawaiian beach amid crashing waves. The organization named it one of AFI's top 100 most romantic films of all time. Lancaster's performance earned him an Oscar nomination for Best Actor, and the film would be one of the most critically acclaimed Lancaster ever made. For his own company, Lancaster produced and starred in His Majesty O'Keefe, 1954. A South Sea Island tale shot in Fiji. It was co-written by James Hill, who would soon become a part of the Hecht-Lancaster partnership. Hecht and Lancaster left Warner's for United Artists for what began as a two-picture deal, the first of which was to be Apache, 1954, starring Lancaster as a Native American. They followed it with another western, Vera Cruz, 1954, co-starring Gary Cooper and produced by Hill. Both films were directed by Robert Aldrich and were hugely popular. United Artists signed Hecht-Lancaster to a multi-picture contract to make seven films over 2 years. These included films which Lancaster did not act in. Their first was Marty, 1955, based on Paddy Chayefsky's TV play starring Ernest Borgnine and directed by Delbert Mann. It won both the Academy Award for Best Picture and the Palme d'Or Award at the Cannes Film Festival. It also earned $2 million on a budget of $350,000. Vera Cruz had been a huge success, but Marty secured Hecht-Lancaster as one of the most successful independent production companies in Hollywood at the time. Without Hill, Hecht and Lancaster produced The Kentuckian, 1955, was directed by Lancaster in his directorial debut. He also played a lead role. Lancaster disliked directing and only did it once more, in the 1970s. Lancaster still had commitments with Wallace, and made The Rose Tattoo, 1955, for him, starring with Anna Magnani and directed by Daniel Mann. It was very popular at the box office and critically acclaimed, winning Magnani an Oscar. In 1955, Hill was made an equal partner in the company and the name was upgraded to Hecht-Hill-Lancaster, releasing their first film in 1956, Trapeze, in which Lancaster performed many of his own stunts. Trapeze, co-starring Tony Curtis and Gina Lollobrigida, went on to become the production company's top box office success. United Artists expanded its deal with HHL. In 1956, Lancaster and Hecht entered the music industry with the companies Hecht-Lancaster and Buzzle Music and Canwork Music. The HHL team impressed Hollywood with its success, as Life wrote in 1957, after the independent production of A Baker's Dozen of Pictures, it has yet to have its first flop, they were also good pictures. In late 1957 they announced they would make 10 films worth $14 million in 1958. Lancaster did two films for Wallace, to complete his eight-film commitment for that produce, The Rainmaker, 1956, with Katharine Hepburn, which earned Lancaster a Golden Globe nomination for Best Actor, and Gunfight at the OK Corral, 1957, with Kirk Douglas, directed by John Sturges, which was a huge commercial hit. Lancaster worked with Tony Curtis again on Sweet Smell of Success, 1957, a co-production between Hecht-Hill-Lancaster and Curtis' own company Curtly Productions, co-owned with his wife, Janet Lee. The movie, directed by Alexander McKendrick, was a critical success but a commercial disappointment. Over the years it has come to be regarded as one of Lancaster's greatest films. Hecht-Hill-Lancaster produced seven additional films in the late 1950s. Four starred Lancaster: Run Silent, Run Deep, 1958, a war film with Clark Gable, directed by Robert Wise, which was mildly popular; Separate Tables, 1958, with Kerr and Rita Hayworth, who married James Hill, based on a play by Terence Rattigan, which won Oscars for David Niven and Wendy Hiller, and was a success; The Devil's Disciple, 1959, with Douglas and Laurence Olivier, which lost money, and saw Lancaster fire McKendrick during shooting; and The Unforgiven, 1960, with Audrey Hepburn, which was a critical and commercial disappointment. Three were made without Lancaster, all of which lost money: The Bachelor Party, 1957, from another TV play by Chayefsky, and directed by Delbert Mann; Take a Giant Step, 1959, about a black student; and Summer of the 17th Doll, 1960, from an Australian play, shot in Australia and Britain. Additionally, Hecht-Hill-Lancaster served as the production company for the 1960-1961 TV series Whiplash. The Hecht-Hill-Lancaster Productions Company dissolved in 1960, after Hill ruptured his relation with both Hecht and Lancaster. Lancaster played the title role in Elmer Gantry, 1960, written and directed by Richard Brooks for United Artists. Lancaster won the 1960 Academy Award for Best Actor, a Golden Globe Award, and the New York Film Critics Award for his performance. Hecht and Lancaster worked together on The Young Savages, 1961, directed by John Frankenheimer and produced by Hecht. Sidney Pollack worked as a dialogue coach. Lancaster starred in Judgment at Nuremberg, 1961, for Stanley Kramer, then did another with Hecht and Frankenheimer, replacing Charles Crichton, Birdman of Alcatraz, 1962. The second film earned Lancaster a Best Actor Oscar nomination. Hecht went on to produce five films without Lancaster's assistance, through his company Harold Hecht Films Productions between 1961 and 1967, including another Academy Award winner, Cat Ballou, starring Lee Marvin and Jane Fonda. Lancaster made A Child is Waiting, 1963, with Judy Garland. It was produced by Kramer and directed by John Cassavetes. He went to Italy to star in The Leopard, 1963, for Luchino Visconti, co-starring Alain Delon and Claudia Cardinale. It was one of Lancaster's favorite films and was a big hit in France but failed in the US, though the version released was much truncated. He had a small role in The List of Adrian Messenger, 1963, for producer/star Kirk Douglas, and then did two for Frankenheimer: 7 Days in May, 1964, a political thriller with Douglas, and The Train, 1964, a World War II action film. Lancaster had Frankenheimer replace Arthur Penn several days into filming. Lancaster starred in The Hallelujah Trail, 1965, a comic western produced and directed by John Sturges, which failed to recoup its large cost. He had a big hit with The Professionals, 1966, a western directed by Brooks and co-starring Lee Marvin. In 1966, at the age of 52, Lancaster appeared nude in director Frank Perry's film The Swimmer, 1968, in what the critic Roger Ebert called his finest performance. Prior to working on The Swimmer, Lancaster was terrified of the water because he did not know how to swim. In preparation for the film, he took swimming lessons from UCLA swim coach Bob Horn. Filming was difficult and clashes between Lancaster and Perry led to Sidney Pollack coming in to do some filming. The film was not released until 1968, when it proved to be a commercial failure, though Lancaster remained proud of the movie and his performance. In 1967, Lancaster formed a new partnership with Roland Kibbe, who had already worked as a writer on five Lancaster projects, Ten Tall Men, The Crimson Pirate, Three Sailors and a Girl, in which Lancaster made a cameo appearance, Vera Cruz and the Devil's Disciple. Through Norland Productions, Lancaster and Kibbe produced The Scalp Hunters, 1968, directed by Sidney Pollack. Lancaster followed it with another film from Pollack, Castle Keep, 1969, which was a big flop. So was The Gypsy Moths, 1969, for Frankenheimer. Lancaster had one of the biggest successes of his career with Airport, 1970, one of the biggest box office hits of 1970 and, at that time, reportedly the highest-grossing film in the history of Universal Pictures. He went into a series of westerns, Lawman, 1971, directed by Michael Winner, Valdez is Coming, 1971, for Norlin, and Olzana's Raid, 1972, directed by Aldrich and produced by himself and Hecht. None were particularly popular, but Olzana's Raid has become a cult film. Lancaster did two thrillers, Scorpio, 1973, with Winner and Executive Action, 1973. Lancaster returned to directing with The Midnight Man, 1974, which he also wrote and produced with Kibbe. He made a second film with Visconti, Conversation Piece, 1974, and played the title role in the TV series Moses the Lawgiver, 1974. Lancaster was one of many names in 1900, 1975, directed by Bernardo Bertolucci, and he had a cameo in Buffalo Bill and the Indians, or Sitting Bull's History Lesson, 1976, for Robert Altman. He played Shimon Perez in the TV movie Victory at Entebbe, 1977, and had a support role in The Cassandra Crossing, 1976. He made a fourth and final film with Aldrich, Twilight's Last Gleaming, 1977, and had a title role in The Island of Dr. Moreau, 1978. Lancaster was top billed in Go Tell the Spartans, 1978, a Vietnam War film. Lancaster admired the script so much he took a reduced fee and donated money to help the movie be completed. He was in Zulu Dawn, 1979. Lancaster began the 1980s with a highly acclaimed performance in Atlantic City, 1980, directed by Louis Malle, which earned him a Best Actor nomination. He had key roles in Cattle Annie and Little Bridges, 1981, The Skin, 1982, with Cardinale, Marco Polo, 1982, and Local Hero, 1983. By now Lancaster was mostly a character actor in features, as in The Osterman Weekend, 1983, but he was the lead in the TV movie Scandal Sheet, 1985. He was in Little Treasure, 1985, directed by Alan Sharp, who had written Olzana's Raid, On Wings of Eagles, 1986, for TV, as Bull Simons, Barnum, 1986, for TV, in the title role, Tough Guys, 1986, with Douglas, 1986, for German TV, Control, 1987, in Italy, Rocket Gibraltar, 1988, and The Jeweler's Shop, 1989. His first big hit in a while was Field of Dreams, 1989, in which he played a support role as Moonlight Graham. He was in the miniseries The Betrothed, 1989. Lancaster's final performances included The Phantom of the Opera, 1990. For TV, 1990, as Leon Klinghoffer, and Separate but Equal, 1992, with Sidney Poitier. For his contribution to the motion picture industry, Lancaster has a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame at 6801 Hollywood Boulevard. Lancaster appeared in a total of 17 films produced by his agent Harold Hecht. Eight of these were co-produced by James Hill. He also appeared in eight films produced by Hal B. Wallace and two with producer Mark Hellinger. Although Lancaster's work alongside Kirk Douglas was mostly known as a successful pair of actors, Douglas in fact produced four films for the pair, through his production companies Brina Productions and Joel Productions. Roland Kibbe also produced three Lancaster films. Lancaster was also cast in two Stanley Kramer productions. John Frankenheimer directed five films with Lancaster: The Young Savages, 1961, Birdman of Alcatraz, 1962, 7 Days in May, 1964, The Train, 1964, and The Gypsy Moths, 1969. He was directed four times by Robert Aldrich, three times by Robert C. Idmack and Sidney Pollack, and twice by Byron Haskin, Daniel Mann, John Sturges, John Huston, Richard Brooks, Alexander McKendrick, Luchino Visconti, and Michael Winner. Roland Kibbe wrote for seven Lancaster films. Lancaster used makeup veteran Robert Schiffer in 20 credited films, hiring Schiffer on nearly all the films he produced. Lancaster vigorously guarded his private life. He was married three times. His first two marriages, to June Ernst from 1935 to 1946 and Norma Anderson from 1946 to 1969, ended in divorce. His third marriage, to Susan Martin, lasted from September 1990 until his death in 1994. All five of his children were with Anderson: Bill, who became an actor and screenwriter; James, Susan, Joanna, and Sayal, pronounced Sheila. Friends say he claimed he was romantically involved with Deborah Kerr during the filming of From Here to Eternity in 1953. However, Kerr stated that while there was a spark of attraction, nothing ever happened. He reportedly had an affair with Joan Blondell. In her 1980 autobiography, Shelley Winters claimed to have had a long affair with him. Recent biographers and others believe that Lancaster was bisexual, and that he had intimate relationships with men as well as women. According to testimony in Kate Buford's Burt Lancaster, An American Life, Lancaster was devotedly loyal to his friends and family. Old friends from his childhood remained his friends for life. Lancaster was a vocal supporter of liberal political causes, and frequently spoke out in support of racial minorities, including at the March on Washington in 1963. He was a vocal opponent of the Vietnam War and right-wing political movements such as McCarthyism, and he helped pay for the successful defense of a soldier accused of fragging, murdering, another soldier during that war. In 1968, Lancaster actively supported the presidential candidacy of anti-war Senator Eugene McCarthy of Minnesota, and frequently spoke on his behalf during the Democratic primaries. He campaigned heavily for George McGovern in the 1972 presidential election. In 1985, Lancaster joined the fight against AIDS after his close friend, Rock Hudson, contracted the disease. He campaigned for Michael Dukakis in the 1988 presidential election. The centennial of Lancaster's birth was honored at New York City's Film Society of Lincoln Center in May 2013 with the screening of 12 of the actor's best-known films, From the Killers to Atlantic City. Despite his Protestant background and upbringing, Lancaster identified himself as an atheist later in life. As Lancaster grew older, he became increasingly plagued by atherosclerosis, barely surviving a routine gallbladder operation in January 1980. Following two minor heart attacks, he had to undergo an emergency quadruple coronary bypass in 1983, after which he was extremely weak. However, he still managed to continue acting. In 1988, Lancaster was well enough to attend a congressional hearing with old colleagues such as James Stewart and Ginger Rogers to protest against media magnate Ted Turner's plan to colorize various black and white films from the 1930s and 1940s. Lancaster's acting career ended after he suffered a stroke on November 30, 1990, which left him partly paralyzed and largely unable to speak. He died in his apartment in Century City, California, from a third heart attack at 4:50 a.m. on October 20, 1994. At the age of 80, just 13 days shy of his 81st birthday. He was cremated and his ashes were buried under a large oak tree in Westwood Memorial Park located in Westwood Village, California. A small, square ground plaque inscribed only with Burt Lancaster 1913-1994 marks his final resting place. Upon his death, as he requested, he had no memorial or funeral service. One of his final roles was that of Leon Klinghoffer in Voyage of Terror, the Achille Lauro hijacking. For a number of years, exhibitors voted Lancaster as among the most popular stars. Spanish music group Hombres G released an album named La Cagaste, Burt Lancaster, You Messed Up, Burt Lancaster, in 1986. Thomas Hart Benton painted a scene from The Kentuckian as part of the film's marketing. Lancaster posed for the painting, also known as The Kentuckian. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.